have to say, this year's been interesting. The rise of digital payments anyway, due to COVID. Some big investors throwing the towel in and saying, fine, I was a skeptic. I've changed my mind. Square, PayPal getting involved. What's driving the gains this year in your mind?
Cash is still relevant, but cash is no longer king.
So we've just been hodling. Our thesis is that Bitcoin is gold 2.0, that it will disrupt gold. And if it does that, it has to have a market cap of $9 trillion.
Many governments around the world are printing more fiat currencies. Here in the United States, you see, you know, trillions of dollars of stimulus, and that means that we're inflating the U.S. dollar.
Bitcoin rising above $19,000 as it closes in on its record high price.
There's a false narrative that Americans are using cash less now than ever before.
It's just, you know, Bitcoin is the kind of winner of a supply and demand exercise.
All the debt that's increased in the U.S., the money printing, and so how do you defend against that? And I think a lot of people are starting to realize that Bitcoin is really the best defense and offers the opportunity for an asymmetric return of something like 25 to 40x from here. And I don't think there's an asset in the universe that can credibly offer that kind of potential and protect against inflation.
Yo, what's up mga peeps? Kamusta kayong lahat dyan? Welcome back sa aking YouTube channel. At sa araw na ito, ay pag-uusapan pa rin natin ang tungkol sa mga bagong updates sa mundo ng cryptocurrency. Let's go! So bago tayo magsimula mga peace, kung bago ka sa aking channel, ay huwag mong kalimutan ang mag-hit ng subscribe at isama mo na ang notification bell. Sama mo yung all para naman ma-notify kita sa lahat ng video na gagawin natin. So mga peace, kamusta kayong lahat? At welcome again sa aking channel mga peace. So sa intro na yon mga peace, may kita natin na yun nga, sobrang nagbabago na ang financial world natin gamit nga ang mga cryptocurrency. Ayan, I hope na mga peace ay magkaroon kayo ng idea at pay attention sa nagaganap regarding dito nga sa ating mga cryptocurrency. So, unti-unti na, unti-unting nagbabago. People are not using money according to the survey. At napakarami ng na-involve ngayon sa cryptocurrency. So, again, way back 2015, walang alam ang mga tao sa cryptocurrency. Ako nagsisimula pa lang ako noon. Pero nakita ko na nga na merong future about this Bitcoin, Ethereum, XRP. So hindi nga tayo nagkamali. The world is changing, like mails into emails, 'di ba? Phone into cellphone, the connections, the 4G's, the internet connection, and right now it is cryptocurrency. So bago tayo pumunta lahat sa ating mga topic, check na uli natin as of December 3 of 11:40 p.m. So magandang gabi sa inyong lahat. Ay Bitcoin is at on 19,400. So papapansin ko ulit sa inyo na ang circulating supply ni Bitcoin ay nasa 18,561,118 Bitcoin. So sabi ko nga, lagi ko sinasabi na meron lang tayong 21 million na Bitcoin na magsi-circulate sa buong mundo. And I hope mga peace ay nagpipay kayo ng attention regarding on this. Ang Ethereum natin, ito na, nasa 612.92. Okay? In 7 days, meron siyang 17.32%. Samantalang ang Bitcoin naman ay may 12.20% na profit. Si XRP naman, So napakalaking potential ni XRP. Sabi nga sa mga report natin, we have so much space for XRP to grow. So ito yung isa sa mga meron tayong coins right now. At ngayon ang price niya ay 0.629910 dollars. Onti na lang mag $1 na to, mga peace. Okay, so sa dami ngayon ng naglalabas ang investment using cryptocurrency, we need to warn everyone, mga peace. Ito nga galing sa Coin Market Cap Capital blog, warning: phishing scam is very easy to fall for. So ano ba yung phishing? So kukunin nito yung lahat ng details mo, at eventually, mga peace, baka sakaling malaki yung chance na makuha nila yung mga tokens mo or mga cryptos mo na nasa wallet. So maging aware tayo dito, mga peace. Una-una, wag tayo magbukas ng kahit na ano sa email natin. Once na, lalo na if you're using cryptocurrency, mga pisa, wag tayo mag-open ng hindi natin kilalang email. Kadalasan pumupunta siya sa spam eh. Pero yung iba na ma-manipulate, pumupunta talaga dun sa primary mails mo. Kaya, peace. Excuse me. Mag-ingat kayo dito, okay? Basahin na rin natin to. Cipher Trace is warning MetaMask user to remain vigilant after receiving an uptick of alert that funds are being stolen through a phishing attack. So, mag-ingat nga tayo dito. Ito nga sabi nila, Cipher Trace, mag-ingat kayo dito. MetaTask, mag-ingat kayo dito, mga peace. According to the blockchain intelligence firm, a malicious Chrome browser extension is masquerading as an official MetaMask product. Malicious Chrome browser. Ito. Chrome browser. So, mag-ingat. Mag-ingat kayo, mga peace. The extension leaks to a domain that we created just 7 days ago with a design that's intended to mimic MetaMask official website. Can you tell difference between two sites? Answer is the bottom. Ito yung MetaMask. So meron atang isa nito. Mga pisa, mag-ingat kayo. Photography shared by CyberTrace shown that it is near impossible to tell the two sites apart, meaning crypto enthusiasts need to get savvy and double click the URL. So MetaMask.io. Ito. Okay? According to the company, the suspicious website was first uncovered by the Twitter user on November. I shared at MetaMask in Google. I found a suspicious ad. Please retweet. Pick twitter.com IMTICN9 by Diego Mazo on last November 28. Even though he tagged MetaMask in his tweet, which appeared to show that fraudulent site was being advertised on Google, MetaMask didn't publicly reply to this trend. Cipher Trace said, "We have alerted and reached out to MetaMask to help take down this malicious browser extension. As always, stay vigilant." So, stay vigilant, mga pisa. Ito ang sabi ng Cipher Trace using MetaMask. Okay, hindi sila nag-reply daw regarding dito sa tweet na to. Why this news matters? Phishing scams are sadly a common part of online world in need. They are not even reserved for crypto project. PayPal users often have the grapple with emails that appears to be from the payment platform even though they are not. Ayan, katulad niyan, may mga mag-receive ka nga talaga ng mga email. So, vigilant. Be vigilant, mga peace. Top tips for staying safe include: be cautious whether a company contact you directly. Ayan, medyo nahirapan din ako dito kasi may mga nag-i-email sa akin pero apparently hindi ko sila pinapansin. Kasi minsan kasi hindi nakakapaniwala eh, okay? Always check the URL of the website before logging in or depositing a cash. Check nyo mga piece. Watch out for the website that are poor imitation of the digit original. They can sometimes be littered with typos. So may mga mali daw na CryptoGate ito. Near impossible the website meaning ito siya yung sabi yun nga, double check the URL, yung MetaMask. I-check natin itong maigi mga pisa, huwag kayong masyadong tweet ng tweet. Okay? Contact the company customer service team if you're in doubt. Yan lang yung lagi. So, anyone can fall for phishing scam, even experienced investors. Here's a look of 9 things that everyone should know before investing in cryptocurrency. So, subscribe to our newsletter. You're missing out if you haven't subscribed to the newsletter. Click here to get top story of analysis inbox everyday answer. The second screen was the phishing scam. Kaya mag-ingat kayo sa lahat ng mga nakikita nyo or nag-send sa inyo ng email. Yun lang, pinaka-ano lang natin, advice natin dito is mag-ingat. Dahil once na, yun nga, napasok nila yung emails mo, yung account mo, or even your computer, wala na. Wala tayong magagawa dyan. Kaya, ingat-ingat mga peace. Okay?